So this is the outcome. And again, this is how you should report the outcome here. I'm not going to go into detail. You can take a look yourself. There's one thing I want to mention here. So under the outcome, under the t-test and the biological effect, you have this part. How effective was the pairing? And you get a p-value there also and a correlation coefficient. So what does this p-value tell you? The p-value tells you whether or not it made sense to use a paired setup. And how does he calculate that? Well, he calculates a correlation between before and after. So when you have a paired setup, so the same patients in the two groups, you expect that there will be a correlation between the values of that come from the same patient. So if patient A has high values in control, he'll probably also have high values in the other group. Yeah? So you expect a correlation here, a high correlation. So that's what he's calculating, and then he's seeing if the calculation is as high as you would expect. So and as you can see here, he is not happy with the results here. So he's saying, no, the pairing was not effective. Now, why am I explaining this? Well, the reason is that you should not look at this. You should just ignore him here. He means well, but the fact whether you're going to use a dependent or an independent setup in your experiment should be determined by the biology and not by a stupid p-value that he is calculating. Yeah? So just ignore this. If it makes biological sense to use a paired setup, so to use the same set of patients before and after, then you do that.